Well, Margot, we want to tell you and our viewers that we now know that this train was traveling at 79 miles per hour when it threw on its emergency brakes. It saw the tractor trailer sitting right on the tracks. There simply was not enough time to come to a complete stop before, of course, hitting that tractor trailer, which is still sitting on the tracks right now. Now, people who were on that train, I spoke with them just a few minutes after this happened, and they said the force was so powerful, it made them lunge forward. Some walked away with just a few bumps and bruises altogether, but once that train came to a stop and they realized they had, in fact, been in a train accident, they began to evacuate immediately. Now, the engine, the front part of this train, I don't know if we can take you over here, actually erupted in flames. The other three cars are all passenger rail cars. So folks began evacuating immediately. Some of them walked out of the back of this train. Others had to break through windows to get out and get to safety. And here are some of the accounts from people who were inside, as well as those who were on the street and actually watched this crash happen.
Felt the train kind of lunge forward. He hit the brakes. You could definitely tell he hit the brakes. And then all of a sudden there was impact, a lot of noise, stuff breaking around you. Kind of one of those surreal moments where you're like, I've seen this happen before, but I've never been involved in it. Puts a different perspective on things for sure.
It's indescribable. It loud, very loud crash, and then the engine on the train immediately was engulfed in flames and then derailed.
And you can see right behind me a briefing going on with the responders that are here on scene. It's going to be a long and messy cleanup today. We can tell you that they're bringing in heavy equipment from Norfolk Southern to try and get some of these rail cars out of the way and get this town back to normal right now. But the other part of this, beyond the minor injuries, is part of that cleanup involves a diesel fuel spill. We know that this train was carrying 1,900 gallons of diesel fuel when it left Raleigh, headed to Charlotte. And right now, we know that there were 500 gallons siphoned out, but then the remaining oil left, or gas, I should say, left, actually spilled out into the grassy area here right in the main intersection of Bedman. So they're working with hazmat crews to try and get that cleaned up as we speak. And we're told that this rail tracks could be closed for at least few more hours well into tonight. And of course, anyone taking a train on Amtrak from Charlotte up to New York or from Raleigh to Charlotte, those routes will be disrupted for the remainder of the day. Margo, back to you.
Well, Kim, during the DOT briefing a short while ago, we heard them talking about this being a dangerous crossing and that there were warning signs there as well. Can you elaborate on that?
We sure can. That's a whole nother element of this story right now, is why the truck driver decided to take a risk crossing this particular train track, because we're told this is there's a hump over this train track, and there's actually a warning sign that says, you know, if you're a low riding car, don't try to cross these tracks. They say the driver, DOT officials specifically said the driver simply did not use common sense by trying to make it over these tracks with a low boy carrying a heavy construction equipment. And we know that he was stuck on these tracks for at least a few minutes before this train even came by, that he got out of the car, tried to move the truck, then got back in, and then he saw the train coming, and an eyewitness told me they saw him jump out of that truck and run to safety. So, you know, this is somewhat of a dangerous intersection because of that hump over these railroad tracks, but DOT officials say they have the warning signs up, that people do need to use common sense, and at this point, there's not much more they can do to make this intersection safer.